Hi, my name is Kevin Brookhauser, and I'm a high school English teacher in Monterey, California, and a Google certified teacher and trainer. And I want to talk to you a little bit about Google Drive and Google Docs. Ever since we started using Drive and Docs at our school, the level of productivity, collaboration, and engagement has dramatically increased. At its heart, Drive and Docs is a document creation suite that allows users to create text documents, presentations, spreadsheets, web forms, drawings, and much, much more, all within the web browser. Google Drive documents are incredibly useful because they can be created, stored, and shared using any computer with a connection to the web. Google Drive and Docs is quite simply the best way to collaborate with others on group projects. Docs is a powerful word processor that allows for rich formatting and seamless collaboration with others. Slides allows you to create engaging slideshows for presentations that look as good on the projector as they do embedded in a website. With Sheets, students and educators can create powerful spreadsheets that are incredibly fast and harness the power of the web for dynamic formulas and calculations. Forms works with spreadsheets and allow users to create media-rich web forms. All the data entered in the forms are populated in a spreadsheet. Drawings allow users to create and collaborate on drawings with a wide variety of tools. Homework never gets lost or forgotten with Drive because it's all automatically saved, stored, and backed up to the cloud. Forgotten flash drives? Forget about it. My students can access all of their work, even if they did leave their computers at home. The most exciting part about using Drive in the classroom is how easy it is to collaborate with others. Rather than attaching files to emails, students and educators can share access to documents so they can work together on projects in real time. The entire history of the document is constantly saved and archived, so anyone can go back in time to see who did what, when. As an educator, I love the commenting system in Drive. With a few easy keyboard shortcuts, I can provide feedback in a digital paper as quickly as I could with a red pen on a traditional paper. But in Docs and Drive, students can respond to my comments instantly to ask follow-up questions and suggest solutions. Rather than just correcting my students' work, we now have a real conversation about writing and ideas. Of course, I can easily upload and convert a wide variety of document types to my Drive, so I can use what I already have on file. Fast conversion leads to easy collaboration. Want to store and share other file formats in Drive? No problem. Upload any file you can think of to Drive, and you'll be able to share it however you want and access it from anywhere. Because Drive and Docs harness the power of the web, limitless resources are at a click away using the Research panel. Students can research in one window while composing in another. Citing sources correctly has never been easier. Organizing files and folders is a matter of drag and drop. Folders can be shared the same way files can, so when a folder is shared with a team, all the files in that folder are likewise shared. Shared folders is a great way for teams working on larger projects with multiple documents. I like to use documents in Drive rather than handouts. Instead of running hundreds of paper copies through the photocopy machine, I simply create a document, share it with anyone with the link can view, and then post that link to my classroom website. I save a ton of paper this way. And if I need to make a change, I simply make it on the doc, and the changes are automatically updated for my students. With Google Docs and Drive, I actually spend less time in my classroom dealing with technology and more time focusing on academic work and dynamic projects. Google Drive is part of the Google Apps for Education suite of software. Creating and collaborating is super easy to use, and it's fantastic for teachers and teaching. For those of you watching this training video as a part of our basic series, you may check your understanding of this video lesson by taking the Check Your Knowledge quiz below. And for more resources, please review the additional links on this basics lesson and visit google.com/education.